This is my homemade flat lap machine. Pretty simple. It's a treadmill motor being ran by an adjustable potentiometer, a light switch, and an on-off switch. I hollowed out a computer power supply and robbed the fan from it. I'll show some pictures of what it looks like torn apart. I got a light running up off of it, obviously, for my light, my on-off switch for it itself. And then I can adjust the speed if I want to. I put a bar in over here for water. A little top just to prevent stuff from getting in it. A little adjustable spout so I can adjust the feed of water as I need. And inside of it, I might have to do this two-handed, sorry. Inside of it's pretty simple. The hose out of the way. So down inside of it is just a treadmill motor. I got an Arbor off of eBay or Amazon, one of those, for like under $20. And I just mounted the motor up with a plate, and I added a strap just to kind of brace it down, just to help. Yeah, that's just a Nordic Track treadmill motor. I chose it because they can be ran in forward or reverse, and they work really well. You can run them on with adjustable speed. I just took a metal bar and ran the cord up and out to a light that I salvaged, and the cord just runs through the middle of the tube and out to the light just to keep everything over. Put a little piece of plastic in the way for a splash guard because it does get a little messy. And then the motor just simply runs with the power switch, and you can really ramp it up if you want to. And it's just, obviously, it's all wood construction with a little bit of vinyl, just vinyl material on top with some little set screws so there are no sharp edges. I can lean my arms against it without getting cut. And it's all wood construction. And then I got a little catch bottle down here for garbage water. And I used a angel food cake pan. And I just tapped a hole in it with a hose and glued it all shut with automotive RTV. And that works as my catch pan. Oops, got the little hose in there again. That just sits down there. I ran the hose down into the bottle as a catch for overflowing water so I don't get water all over my motor. And that just sits in there freely. Run him down here lower. And then I had to buy all the various grits. I bought all these on Amazon, actually.
3,000, 2,000, 1,200, 800, 600, 320, 240, 180 grit. I don't necessarily need all these grits, but I chose them all, so depending on what I wanted to grind or do, I have all the choices available to me. They run maybe around $15 a piece, depending on what you get. These are all just Chinese grades, so they work. They probably won't last as long as better ones, but I was trying to do this on a budget. And then you could probably make this something like this, but I chose just to buy one of these, and it's a machined backing plate. This little sucker was about $50. As you can see, it's machined, and I just wanted it straight and balanced from the get-go. You know, I didn't want to mess around with something not balanced with my homemade machine already. Yeah, so you just gotta put that down on there on your backing plate. Pick whatever grit you're gonna use. Like I like to use the 80 grit, just doing agate and other material that's pretty hard for shaping. And you can just change it out as you decide you want to change your grits. You just change them, and it's pretty simple. Power's on. It'll move around a little bit until it settles. Very basic, very simple. It's just a treadmill motor sitting upright, mounted onto wood with some metal plate and some holes drilled to hold it in place. And then just using that balance plate or backing plate is very important. Getting a very nice balanced backing plate so it runs smooth. And then just make sure you add a lot of water when you're grinding things. I usually keep a little container of water here to dip the stones on, as well as water dripping, just to keep it really wet, because I don't have continuous running water in my garage. Yeah, I will share some still shots of the inside of my control, how I did that, and I have a few other just basic photos of that. My original build of this, unfortunately, the video I was going to share, the SD card has corrupted data or corrupted file, I don't know, and I've tried to save it and I can't seem to save it. So this is the best I can do for this. But I would say altogether, I'm probably into this flat lap machine maybe like $250. But that's again because each one of these guys was around $15 a piece and up, and then $50 for the balance plate. The treadmill motor was donated to me from my aunt Vivian, thank you very much, and my cousin Jackie who helped deliver it, thank you, that thing was a beast. But yeah, so either you got to get a free treadmill or you have to purchase one, and then I paid, you know, $5 for a power supply. I had to buy a speed control to convert the 12 volt or to convert the 120 to run the treadmill motor to the proper voltage, I guess. I'm not an electrician. I followed a few other people's videos, but I figured it out. It wasn't too hard. And I wanted to run the potentiometer, which I guess if I didn't run the potentiometer and I ran this in full speed or something, I probably wouldn't have had to buy as much, but I wanted to be able to adjust it, and I want to be able to lower the speed of this so it's not flying or, you know, crazy ridiculous, so I could actually grind rocks and not heat them up and melt them. Yeah, I will share some steel shots with a little bit of explanation of what I did. Again, I would say material, probably about $250 total, including the wood and everything. But that's because I got the treadmill for free. If you have to pay it, maybe a little more. And if you decide you don't need as many grits as me, I'm sure you could virtually get away with maybe like 4 grades of grit actually to do a nice stone polish down and polish it out, or there's other alternatives. But I wanted everything I can get my hands on grit wise, so I went with this. I do like to hand facet some little stones. I call them my pirate gems, and I like to do them by hand, and this way I can. It's a lot easier than trying to use sandpaper. Yeah, anyway, I will share some still shots, like I said, 3 times now. I will, I'll give a basic brief explanation. If you have any questions, feel free to ask me a question in the comments. I'll happily explain anything I can. If I don't understand it, I'm sure I can refer you to a video or something else of someone else who I probably stole the idea from, to be honest with you, like everyone does nowadays. It's a nice collaboration. Thank you, YouTube and Google. Everybody's putting their heads together and we're all building these wonderful pieces of equipment. So I won't lie, this isn't exactly 100% my idea. This is my style of how I wanted to build it, but the actual way I built it is based off many others' concepts, and I got the idea for the treadmill motor, again, from watching several YouTube videos, and I thought that was really nifty. I was going to use just a basic little 12-volt motor, but you can't really adjust the speed unless you get the right stuff to do it, and it just seemed more expensive and a lot more of a pain in the butt, you know, and I wanted to be able to adjust the speed. And the little speed control I got for this was under $20 on Amazon. I do suggest, if anyone gets one, make sure you get the speed control that has the little 12 volt fan built into it or something, and you can always pull the fan off the speed control and relocate it. This was part of the power supply, and I actually had to take another 12 volt power supply and add it inside there, which again, like I said, I'll show a video of what's inside my box. Or not a video, but I'll share some still shots on here. And if I can ever recover the original build video of this, I will happily share it. But thank you again.